Hey Aries, thanks so much for tuning in. And we're looking at the week, December 29 through January 4th. We're stepping from 2014 into 2015 in the 1 week. So it's always a bit confusing. And as we finish out the week, the year ends as it begins with Jupiter, the planet of abundance, moving backwards. It was moving backwards in Cancer at the beginning of the year, and now it's moving backwards in Leo. Jupiter retrograde is a sign that the return to peace and prosperity that we all desire is nearby, but still in our future. But as we say our farewells to 2014, it's important to note that the other nine planets are in direct motion, which is a good sign that things are moving ahead. Even if you do feel some things are on the back burner and want to stay there, it's not so. Jupiter retrograde isn't a big deal like Mercury or Venus retrograde. On Tuesday, December 30th, the Capricorn Sun dances in a trine with the Taurus Moon, a connection that speaks to the power of love. If planets could talk, Aries, they might be saying something like this: "We look forward to the time when the power of love will replace the love of power. Then our world will know the blessings of peace." Thanks for coming along on the journey throughout 2014 with me, Astro Girl. It's been a really, really wonderful experience. And now we're going to talk about the first week of January, January 1st through 4th, which ends with a full moon in Cancer, which is quite the start to the year. And a full moon in Cancer is going to be transiting your fourth house of home, family, domesticity. So you could have realized during the holidays that something needs to give. Maybe you did all the work and your partner was kind of lazy over the holidays, or you spent a lot more money, you were disappointed with the gift exchange. Maybe you've had relatives staying in your house and they seem to think that they're staying there longer. Maybe your flatmate needs to be given notice. You are cleaning house. Cleaning out your closets, emotional and your clothing closets, doing some summer cleaning, spring cleaning, fall cleaning, whatever it is. The first month of the calendar year is named after Janus, Janus, the two-faced Roman god of gates and doorways who sees both the past and the future. In 2015, Aries, the future looks brighter than it has been in years. And the reason is that there's a game changer on the celestial horizon. The last square in the series of seven Uranus-Pluto clashes, 2000 to 2015 in March, is the signal that the revolution is over. And of course, Uranus is in your sign, so this actually talks to you. No one knows who won the war, and there are walking wounded everywhere. But hey, we're still here. We survived. The 2015 New Year begins on Thursday, January 1st, with idealistic Mars in Aquarius, sitting exactly opposite Jupiter in fiery Leo. Although this opposition is a carryover from last year, it's also a promise of the renewal that's in the works. Jupiter is in retrograde motion, but moves forward mid-April. Until then, it's our job to keep the faith and maintain our inner enthusiasm. The practical Cancer full moon on Sunday, January 4, reminds us to close the back door before we open the front one. This uber responsible full moon is all about taking responsibility for the past, doing the work to make the future a reality. Pluto's co-starring role in the full moon, next to the sun and opposite the moon, is proof that we all have the tools we need to heal our wounds, transform our sorrows, and meet the new year with courage and determination. Now, remember, I have written a 2015 outlook for everybody, so check that out. And I've also done a video for 2015, the new year, a sneak peek, so check that out. Have a great start to 2015. Happy New Year, Aries.